بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Brothers and sisters, Muslims and Muslimat, a very good Friday to all. الحمد لله in Singapore at this moment. This is the first Jum'ah that we have been able to perform after several months of not being able to perform Jum'ah in our mosque due to the COVID-19 spread and the pandemic that we all know today has gone throughout the world. Just recently, I've received a video of which our previous Mufti, Dr. Muhammad Fatris Bakaram, has also given his way in and he given his views on it. In that video, the speaker, a charismatic speaker, says this: those who pray Jama'ah or Jum'ah in a situation like we do now in Singapore and in many places in the world, where we pray with a distance between one another, a distance of 1 meter, which is known in some places and in Singapore as safety distancing, to avoid and prevent ourselves from infecting others or being infected by others at the same time. Therefore, there's always that recommended safety distancing by the health authorities and also medical experts. He said, those who follow such instructions are cattles and sheep, which I think is a denigrating reference to people who are sincerely and who really, really wants to perform the prayers. Now, let me put this into perspective. What is our scholars' view? And by scholars, I mean ulama. Ulama, and not just charismatic speakers, but ulama in the real sense who have studied traditional Islam. What do they say about us praying together and being physically close together? Undeniably, there are some scholars who say it is wajib and therefore it must be done regardless of what happens. But there are also scholars who say that this act of praying together, physically attached to one another, is at most a sunnah, but a very highly encouraged sunnah. And even if you were to not pray in that situation, for example, in normal circumstances, if you go to pray in jama'ah in normal circumstances, and if you choose to pray apart from your brothers or sisters who are praying beside you, Imam Al-Khatib Al-Sharbini, a scholar within the Shafi'i school of law, says this. He said, the jama'ah prayers is valid. Now, this act of praying apart does not lead to the invalidation of your prayers. That's number one. And however, it is ma'al karaha. It is something which is shunned upon and very discouraged within our Islamic tradition, because Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam in many hadith has encouraged us to pray close to one another. Now, this is one view of the many views. And in our fatwa committee in Singapore, where we subscribe to the Shafi'i school of law and to many other scholars in the world, in the contemporary world today, and this is the views by Shaykh Al-Qaradaghi, this is the views by my mashayikh in Al-Azhar, in Dar al-Ifta, Egypt, in many places in the world, we see scholars allowing Muslims to pray with the safety distance of 1 meter apart or even more from one another. Why? Number one, the praying of jama'ah together, physically together, is, according to some scholars and the authoritative scholars, sunnah. And then the act of praying with a distance in order to prevent somebody from being infected or infecting others, that act of preservation of health of the life of another person is one of the most important and most basic maqasidu shari'ah, higher objective of Islam, which is wajib. And when you have a wajib and then you have a sunnah, then the wajib has to be prioritized. That's number one. Number two is there is also this Islamic legal maxim or qawa'id fiqhiyah, which says dar'ul mafasid muqaddamun ala jalbil masalih, which means the rejection of mafasid, of harm, of anything that can bring bad things to you or negativity, is muqaddamun, is to be prioritized against jalbil masalih, bringing something of benefit. Now, praying together physically to one another, of course, brings with it benefit. But there is a very high risk if you are attached physically together, close by together, you may cough, you may do whatever. You may have possible virus stuck to your body, and then you pray next to one another with physical contact. Then there's the danger of infecting or being infected. So if you follow the legal maxim, there's this benefit, there's this harm. And then what does the Islamic legal maxim says? Dar'ul mafasid. The rejection or the prevention of this mafasid, this danger, this harm, has to be prioritized over jalbil masalih, the bringing of this benefit of praying together. And that is why, not just in Singapore, but in many other places in the world, our scholars say that it is praying in this current form with 1 meter apart from one another is not going against the tradition of Islam. In fact, what it does is actually to ensure the safety and uphold the maqasid of Islam. So be assured, inshallah, that this form of prayer in such situation is not something which goes against our Islamic tradition, but it is in fact upholding our Islamic tradition. And that is why in many places, in Bayt al-Maqdis, in Haramain, in many other places, our scholars have been fine with it, they have permitted it, and it is permissible therefore. I hope this gives you a lot of assurance. I hope this will give you strength, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open up more opportunities for more of us to be able to attend Jum'ah and Jama'ah in the future. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh.